Good evening, folks, and welcome to another edition of An Hour with Bob. I got some useless facts for you tonight. I'll get to them in a little. But first, right off the bat, I got to talk to you. My crew's tired. They're working too hard. We need some more help on the show. We need some, either Monday or Tuesday night, twice a month, we're doing shows. Be here by 6 o'clock at night. You're done by 9, 9:30. You have a lot of fun. You learn how to run cameras. You learn how to run a character generator, do the sound. Maybe even you work yourself up to be a director, like our ace director tonight. Ryan Welch is director tonight. Ryan's the director, huh? And we have Corey on camera right here, and John Flanagan. I don't know where he is. Where's John Flanagan? John Flanagan's, he's floating.
I'm right here.
John's around here somewhere. But seriously, folks, if you're interested in being part of the Hour with Bob crew, get a hold of me either on Facebook, Bob Venturini, An Hour with Bob, or Bob's Big Adventure, any of those Facebook pages, or ventbob@gmail.com. ventbob@gmail.com. You can get a hold of me. See, that's why we need a crew. We need some more crew members over here to help with this stuff. You know, we need a sound tech. We could use a CG operator. We could use a tape operator. We could use a lot. I can remember there were times in the 23 years I've been doing this show, folks, we've had as many as 18 people on the set. Now we're kind of down a few. So we could use a couple helpers, workers. You get paid the same as I get paid, which is zero. But you have a lot of fun, and you meet a lot of interesting and fun people. Like tonight. Tonight, I got a great show tonight. I got a couple beautiful young ladies, and I got a great musician, and I got a great band out of Boston. How can you beat that? And I'm going to start right off with Leah. Leah Jones, how are you doing?
I'm good.
Leah's from the Boston area, right?
Yes.
And Leah Jones, you just won the talent competition of the Miss Junior
American Teen.
American Teen, right?
Yes.
Miss Junior American Teen competition, which was held in Rhode Island. It was held at, where was it?
The Alpine.
Alpine Country Club, right?
Yes.
Now, you're a talented dancer, right?
Yes.
And you've been dancing how long?
I've been dancing ever since I was 4 at two different studios.
Really?
Yeah.
And what's your favorite kind of dance?
Hip-hop.
Hip-hop, huh?
Yes.
Now, who's your favorite artist?
Oh,
do you have
hard.
More than one? You don't have to be one. Who are some of your favorite artists? Let's do it that way.
Beyonce.
Yeah?
Ariana Grande. Yeah.
Did you watch her brother on a big, what was he on? He was on one of those shows.
Big Brother?
I think it was Big Brother, wasn't it? Frankie? I think it was on Big Brother.
Maybe.
And the only reason I watched it was because the guy from Central Falls, a cop from Central Falls, he's from Cumberland, but he's a Central Falls police officer, he won it. He was in it and ended up winning it. And I had him on the show right after he won.
Oh, that's cool.
He was here as a guest. And I watched it because it was a local guy on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this year, they don't have any Rhode Islanders on it. They have somebody from Massachusetts, I think, on it, but they don't have any Rhode Islanders on it this year. But that kid, Frankie, mm-hmm. Ariana Grande's brother, was on that. He looked like her, by the way.
Yeah, they look alike.
Yeah. When he was in drag, he looked a lot like her. Because he did that. He did that on that show. But at first, they tried to make he didn't tell anybody who he was. But getting back to you, you've been dancing since you're 4 years old.
Yes.
And two different schools.
Yes.
And now you also was in a pageant before the pageant, this pageant, the junior.
Mm-hmm. I was in two.
Miss. You were in a pageant where?
I was in Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen and Miss Boston Outstanding Teen.
Outstanding Teen. And you're just a teen too, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you're just a teen.
13.
13. When? What month's your birthday?
November.
November. What does that make you? Do you know astrological signs? Do you know that kind of stuff? What is she, a Capricorn?
Sagittarius.
What? Sagittarius? I don't know. Who knows? Anybody know? I don't know. I don't know why I threw that out there, but I usually do because I look for people that are Libras. Anyway, so you like hip-hop.
Yes.
And what kind of dance did you do in the pageant? Did you do hip-hop?
Yes.
What song did you do?
I did the song that I'm going to be performing tonight. Shake Something Instrumental.
And who does that song?
Cali Swag District.
I know I'm out of touch. I have no idea who that is. I have no idea.
Well, it was recommended from my dance teacher, so.
And what do you hope to do in the future in dance? Dance is your future. I mean, dance is the way you want to go in life, right?
Yeah. I hope to be in any type of movie where I'm dancing, either like as a main character or a background dancer, either one.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Like Footloose, do you even know what that is?
Yes.
You do? How about Saturday Night Fever?
Oh, I don't know the one.
Was it Saturday Night Fever or Saturday Night Live? Saturday Night Fever, right? Saturday Night Fever, right? Wasn't it? John Travolta? That was a great movie. Gotta get that. Gotta get Chris. Chris, you gotta get that movie for her. Saturday Night Fever. That was one of the greatest dance movies ever, I think. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you gotta dance to that with a guy doing this stuff, right? Remember that? Huh? Disco? That was the disco craze in the 70s with John Travolta.
Nah.
So you gotta do a song for us tonight? You gotta do a dance?
Yes. I will be dancing tonight for hip hop.
Wow. Well, that's pretty cool. Well, before we get her dancing, you know, you're from Boston area.
Yes.
And as luck would have it, the band I have here tonight is also from Boston.
Whoop, whoop.
Yes, from the Boston area. And you guys hail from where?
Somerville.
Somerville. Yep. Somerville, Mass. Right?
Yeah.
And, who's talking on the mic over there? One of you's got to talk on the mic. Who is?
Hey, I'm Charlie.
Hi, Charlie.
And I'm in a cave.
Charlie's in the cave. We have Charlie, Ben, and Steph, right? Now, are you all from Somerville?
I live in Brighton.
You live in, oh, that's right, we talked about that. I told you, an old girlfriend lived in Brighton, Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. 10 Centola Street, Brighton,
Centola
Massachusetts.
Street.
A long, long time ago. Anyhow, what kind of music do you do? Do you do hip hop?
It's a little bit different.
No. What kind of stuff you do?
Indie, folk, rock kind of stuff.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And you've been together, what, 4 years?
4 years. Me and Steph have been playing together for 4 years, and then we added Benny on drums and our bass player, Eric, 2 years ago.
Oh, and Eric's invisible right now.
He's invisible, yeah.
Yeah. No, Eric couldn't make it tonight, but
you got four. He's got a face for radio, you know?
Oh, you got a face for radio, huh? I like that. I like that, Steph. So mom and dad must really... have a lot of work. Were you taking you around to two dance studios?
Oh, no, I used to do two. Now I'm just with Funk Phenomenon Dance Studios, run by Rhea Briggs Connor and a bunch of other teachers like Larome, Cassandra, Devin.
Wow. And you expect to stay there a while, right?
Yeah. Because as you get older, you can get into the older groups. There are older people like who are in their 20s and they still dance with this company.
Now, what happens as you get older? Well, as you get older, your body changes, right?
Yeah.
So you do different kinds of dances?
No, we do all types of dances, but it's mostly surrounded by hip-hop. So when you go to older groups, you get to be more advanced.
So maybe you do something in the background with, and I have to say this only because I saw him on TV today, 50 Cent, right?
Who's that?
Who's that? I don't feel bad now. 50 Cent, he's too old for you. He's too young for me. So he's in between. Okay. I happened to see him on TV today. I thought it was 3/4, but he was 50 Cent. Anyhow, you gotta do it. There you go. You got that. All right. Well, these guys are going to do a song for us. And you're going to, when we come back from the song, you're going to be ready to do a dance.
Yes. I'll be ready.
Performance for us, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Give us a song there, Box. What? Box of Birds? Wait a minute. Box of Birds?
B-O-B. Bob.
Bob, B-O-B, Box of Birds. No, how did you come up with that name?
We had to come up with a name for a show we were playing, and we didn't have a band name yet. So we were looking online for phrases and euphemisms and stuff like that. And we found one from New Zealand, and it's Box of Birds. If you're feeling like a box of birds this evening, you're feeling happy.
Oh, okay. All right, a Box of Birds. Okay, give us a song, Box of Birds.
This is the first single off our record that's on the desk over there. It's called It's Fine, It's Swell.
Burn
the floor. I can't take no more war. I can't take no more. In the house of learning, I lick my lips, picking the answers gonna miss. Well, the sidewalk calls my name again. I go back home, see Huntsman. It's fine, it's swell. I die and I feel alone again. Jar with a refreshing drink. The house of Belvedere, right where my eyes dust away.
And now, are we ready for a dance number? We ready?
This is a production.
Leah Jones! Wow.
I'm tired watching you, Leah.
That was good. That was great. And wait, look who's here. Look who's here. Get over there. Look. Katie Bergantine, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Now, you had a a big event last week too, right? Or the other, when was it? How long ago?
The pageant?
Yeah.
It was about 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago? Yeah. Wow, I said last week, 2 weeks ago. Yeah, when you get old like me, you don't know what time is, you know?
Understandable.
Hey, don't agree with me. Don't agree with me. Miss Rhode Island teen, right?
Miss Rhode Island's American teenager.
America's teenager.
Yes.
Yes. Now, you look familiar to me. Why is that?
My mom was on the show in about 2012. She was Mrs. Rhode Island America.
There you go. Yeah. I knew you looked familiar. Even though we said it, I knew you looked familiar to me. So how's mom doing?
She's great. She opened up a store. She owns a dress boutique now.
Oh, no kidding. Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, was this your first pageant you were in?
No, I've been doing pageants since before I could walk, really.
Really?
Yeah. My mom used to carry me on stage.
Really? Yeah? Wow. Mm-hmm. How did it feel to win the pageant?
It felt really great and very proud. I'm very excited to be going to Nationals.
Yeah. Which is when? When's the Nationals?
It's about 2 weeks. So.
Where is it?
Coco Keys Resort in New Jersey.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Wow. Fine. And how old are you?
17.
17.
Yeah.
So you got, now if you win this pageant, what happens then? What happens?
I basically become the ambassador for Miss American Teenager. I represent them.
Yeah?
Instead of just representing Rhode Island, all the states.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now where do you go to school?
Coventry. I'm a junior, going to be a senior this year.
Yeah, in Coventry High School?
Yeah.
Now Coventry. What's their team?
Colors. Red and white.
Red and white?
Yeah, the Ochres.
That's right. Yeah. Because I was going to say, I almost mixed them up with West Warwick. West Warwick is the Wizards.
Don't get
right?
us mixed up.
I know that. Oh, God, I know that.
I'm very mad at you.
Yes. Now, are your boyfriend's here? He goes there too?
Yeah, he does.
Does he?
Yeah.
Is he your bodyguard too?
Yeah, he's my bodyguard.
Is he?
Took him with me tonight too.
You what?
I took him with me tonight to be my bodyguard.
Oh, yeah?
So,
so he's your Kevin Costner, is he? Oh, God, when you deal with these young kids, they have no idea, no concept of what I'm talking about. Chris, help me out here, will you? I said bodyguard, you know, Kevin Costner. She has no idea what I'm talking about. Kevin Costner, you know who he is?
No.
No. Kevin Costner is an actor.
Okay.
A pretty good actor, too.
Okay.
Waterworld, wasn't he? He was in that movie, right? Waterworld, wasn't he in that movie? Yeah.
I'm sorry, no.
Oh, that's okay. So you're excited about being in the pageant and winning the pageant.
Mm-hmm. No. Well, hopefully winning it.
I'm
talking about Nationals.
Nationals. Yeah. Speaking of Nationals, did you watch the pageant?
I did.
Miss America pageant?
I watched the Miss USA pageant. I'm proud of Ania. Yeah.
Second runner-up, which is great. It's too bad, like three out of the five of them, including her, stumbled on that last question, which is kind of tough. You know, they put them on the spot.
Yeah.
And it's they froze. Three of them did.
Yeah. I mean, I don't really blame them. They have the whole nation watching them, and those are some tough questions. And
do you remember what her question was?
I believe it was whether. Political correctness, does it hurt
that's what
or
it was
help our
that
society?
Was that's what it was
yeah.
And she stumbled and then she says, could you repeat the question? She's dead. I knew she was dead, but she still ended up second runner-up. I loved her dress,
of course. Yeah, she's absolutely gorgeous. I got the pleasure of meeting her at last year's Miss Rhode Island, so we all knew that she was going to do very well.
I have a picture of her right here. I have a picture of her. She's beautiful. I've met her
she's
before.
Absolutely gorgeous.
We'll keep on talking. So what do you want to do after this pageant here? After you win the American version of the pageant?
Hope I win it.
What are you going to do?
Then I would just be the best ambassador that I could be. I'm hoping to do a lot of community service. I'm starting my own project. I'm going to be selling sugar scrubs.
What's that?
It's for your face. It's like body wash. Sugar scrubs, yeah. And then donating 30% of the profits to, the profits to Hasbro Children's Hospital.
Oh,
Tomorrow
okay.
Fund.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, when you say sugar scrubs, does it have sugar in it?
It does, yeah. Turbinado sugar with like coconut oil and things that are good for your skin.
So it's not, is it a powder or is it a liquid?
It's neither. It's like a solid, like scrub.
Oh.
Like a wash for your face.
Oh, well, that's a teenage thing, right? To get rid of the
anyone can use it, really.
Skin, huh? Do I need it? Can I use it?
You can use it.
Yeah?
You want to smell like coconuts, but it's okay.
I wouldn't smell like other than coconuts? It just comes in coconut flavor?
I'm planning on making a coffee one too.
Now that would be different though.
Yeah, way different.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And they're bars, like a soap bar or something?
No, I have these little mason jars, and you can use about a teaspoon amount at a time, and then just put it on your face, and it exfoliates your face.
You put it, dip your hand
into
it?
Yeah, you go like this, you rub your face like this.
So you get coffee all over your face?
Well, then you wash it off after. Coffee has a lot of antioxidizing properties, so it's very good for your skin.
Yeah, but sugar's not supposed to be good for you, right?
Well, no, it's not good for you, you just don't eat it.
You can't eat it.
It exfoliates the dead skin cells off of your skin.
Really?
Yeah.
So it rips the skin off you.
No, I wouldn't sell anything that rips the skin off you.
I'm just playing with you. By the way, there she is.
She's gorgeous.
Isn't she?
Mm-hmm.
You got that, Corey? you don't have that.
It's too bright.
Too bright? Too bright. She's too bright. She's beautiful.
Absolutely.
She'll be on here. You got it? No, you don't have it. I'm putting it down because you don't have it. You got it or you don't? You can't get it. I counted on you, Cole. I counted on you. Anyhow, what does your boyfriend think of you in pageants now?
What do you think of me in pageants?
No, don't ask him.
I don't know what he thinks of me. He says that he likes it, but
he likes it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Now, are the other guys hitting on you at school now?
Yeah, there's a few. There's a few.
There's a few?
Uh-huh.
All right, you know what? Why don't you hang around with us for a minute?
I will.
Because I got Jason over here. You know Jason? Do you know this?
Jason
Morel. He's been on the show. How many times have you been on my show, Jason? Five? How's that? Five. I said five. That's what I said. Fifth time. Jason hails from the great state of Rhode Island. Jason was a former
soldier
in the Army. And he went to magic school, which I had to learn from him, I didn't even realize they had a magic school. They have a magic school in Hollywood, California.
It's called the Magic Castle.
The Magic Castle.
This is
get to that. I'll get to this young lady. And who's with you tonight? Is that Caitlin?
This is my daughter.
Hi, daughter Caitlin.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
How old are you?
13 years old.
13 years old. And helping dad tonight?
Yes.
I hope he doesn't make you disappear.
Well,
why does everybody say that?
Because that's what magic—that's what magicians do. They make things disappear. disappear.
Well, I'm gonna float on air and I'm gonna appear.
You gotta float on air? Yeah. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. All right, I don't want to say anything more, so I'm not gonna ask any more questions. I'll ask you now, Jason. Mm-hmm. Now, what do you got for us tonight? You got a couple.
I've got couple two tricks. Effects.
Okay, what are they? One is a flotation, I just heard.
I'm gonna do a levitation.
A levitation?
I'm gonna make my daughter float on air.
Float on air?
On air.
On here?
On air.
On air?
On air.
On air here?
Yes.
All right.
In your studio?
In my studio. All right.
Never been done before.
What? Never been done where? Oh, in here?
Yes.
Okay, all right. So how long have you been doing this magic stuff?
35 years.
35 years, wow. All right. Give us and you have another assistant too, don't you?
Well, she actually vanished. But Bob, just come on up real quick.
Oh, you want me to get up?
Yes.
Can I get up? I don't know if I have enough cord to get up. Let me see. I got a little bit. I'm not moving too well. My knee's killing me, so bear with me.
I just want you to walk around the cabinet and look underneath.
I can't walk around here. I can only go so far. Oh, you can turn that then. Let me see.
Okay, is there anything underneath it?
Nope, I can go right. I could send something right underneath.
Is there anything around it?
Nope.
Well then, Maestro, if you please, ladies and gentlemen, and my fans most importantly, watch this carefully. Maestro.
Maestro. Strong joy, my dad.
Thank you very much.
Now, who is this? Alexis?
This is my female assistant, Alexis.
Hi, Alexis.
Hi.
They're just putting the box back together.
Yeah? Wow. Now, you got another trick for us after, right?
Absolutely.
All right.
Great to see you, bud.
Nice to see you. I'll be back to you. Give us a song, will you? The Box of Birds, you. You Box of Birds. Mm-hmm. Stephanie? Box of Birds is back! The Box of Birds. What's with the cowboy hat? That's what I want to know. What's with the cowboy hat?
I like it.
I like the look. No, I do. I like the look.
She's a fan of hats.
It becomes you.
Huh.
It becomes you.
Thank you.
The cowgirl hat, not the cowboy hat, right? It's a cowgirl hat. Hi, folks. We're back on an hour with Bob over here, and this is called a talent night. We're loaded with talent and beauty tonight, folks. Hey. You know, I always draw the useless statistic. What is the most reliable vehicle? Anybody know? What's the most reliable used vehicle to buy? Anybody know? Brand. What's the most reliable used car to buy? Up to 3 years old.
Subaru.
What is it?
Subaru.
Subaru? Come on.
Ryan's saying Toyota.
Ryan's saying Toyota. What does John say?
A Yugo.
Volvo?
What is
Chris?
Daewoo.
Daewoo. I had one of them in Florida one time.
Mercedes.
Good guess. Both of you.
Volvo.
I was
gonna go Volvo too.
Volvo too. All right.
Honda.
The most reliable used vehicle to buy is a Lexus.
Wow.
By far, by the way, by far. And second, for us normal people, is a Toyota. Who said? Ryan said Toyota, which, by the way, Lexus is a Toyota. So number one and number two, and that includes the midsize car, the compact car, the luxury car, they're all Toyotas or Lexuses. And Honda's up there too. The top five are Lexus number one, Toyota number two, Mazda number three, Honda number four, and Audi number five. Nobody even got that one, Audi. Now let me see where the rest of them are. Do you know what's sad? In the top 10, there's only one American car. That's sad. Anybody know what it is? It's only one American car that's in the Ford or Chevy. What'd you say? Pontiac, they don't even make them anymore.
Oldsmobile.
They don't make them either. And by the way, I own a lot of Pontiacs. I own three GTOs back in the day. The most reliable American-made car is a...
General Motors.
Well, it is a General Motors, but which one? It's a Buick. That's not a Buick! You ever see that commercial? That's not a Buick! Yeah, that's that's one of the most reliable American... I love that commercial, by the way. That's, hey, if you remember the commercial, it doesn't matter how stupid it is. If you remember it, that's the important thing. That's all they care about. It's like, right?
Yeah, that's true.
That's what people tell you. When, as long as they remember you, it ain't that they remember you. It ain't what they remember you for. It's the fact that they remember you.
Right.
Like, you want people to remember you, don't you?
I do.
Now, what are you going to, now, what kind of car do you drive?
2012 Volkswagen CC.
A Volkswagen? Wait a minute. You're not even in the top five. Let
oh,
me see.
No.
Let me see where you. Oh, no. Wait a minute. Wait. Wait a minute. Mid-sized car. Volkswagen. Which one? Which model?
CC 2012.
This is a Passat.
That's pretty close to a CC.
Is it? Oh, that's not a large car. Then.
The CC
is that a small
like a
car?
Sportier.
Oh, it's a sports car.
Yeah.
Is it a sports car?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't
not
know.
A true like sports.
I see somebody out there with a beautiful Mercedes. I know that. Somebody's got a beautiful Mercedes. I love Mercedes. That's my favorite car. Who's driving a Mercedes, Chris?
Who's that?
Huh?
Who's that?
I said, who's driving a Mercedes out there? Yeah, that's what I said. That didn't get by me, by the way. I love Mercedes. Anyway, you're not in here. You're a Volkswagen. Well, it's not. Well, it is in here. Yeah, it's in here. It's in like number four. But that's good.
That is.
That's good.
Yeah.
2012, huh?
Yeah.
It's not a standard shift, though, right?
No.
Nobody can drive standard shifts anymore.
No, I can't.
Can you drive one?
No.
I'll bet you if I went around this room, I'll bet you there's not three people in this room can drive a standard shift.
No.
Chris?
What's that?
Can you drive a standard shift?
Yes.
Anybody else? Ben, Ken? What do you mean a little bit?
A little bit.
Now, come on. There's no such thing as a little bit. Then I'll put you on College Hill in Providence where the hill's up like this, a 60-degree angle, and hold it, and have you hold it on the hill.
Your car.
All right, Caitlin. Now, you won 2 weeks ago. You're getting ready for Nationals.
Yeah.
Now, Mom going down there with you?
Yes, she is.
Are you driving down or flying down?
We're driving down.
Driving, yeah.
She won't fly.
Yeah, it's not a far ride. Aww. It's only 4 hours.
Yeah.
Four and a half hours.
Yeah.
All right. Now I'm going to ask you a crazy thing. What's the weirdest thing you ever did?
Because
I asked her to come up with a couple questions.
Yeah.
And that was one of your questions. Now, what's the weirdest thing you ever did?
Before becoming a vegetarian, I ate...
I'm a Venturini. You're a vegetarian?
I'm a vegetarian. I don't think that's the same thing as...
No?
You said no.
a Venturini and a vegetarian aren't the same thing, Corey?
I don't think so.
Aren't they? They're close, though, aren't they?
Close enough.
Yeah.
I mean, they start with a V, so.
It starts with a V, right. Yeah, yeah. What does yours end with? A vegetarian?
N-N.
My end with an N-I. Is that better?
No.
Venturini?
No.
Oh, all right. Now, when did you become a vegetarian?
About 3 years ago.
Why?
Because I believe it's better for you. And half of my family is vegan or vegetarian, so it's just a way.
Now, what's
of
the
life.
Difference between a vegan and a vegetarian?
Vegetarians can't eat meat or fish, and a vegan can't eat meat, fish, or eggs, dairy. Some even go as far as honey.
Oh my God!
I
so
know.
What do they eat? Weeds?
Weeds? No.
Kelp?
I've actually had seaweed.
Lettuce?
It's pretty good.
It is?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. What do you put on a sandwich?
Lettuce? Yeah,
kelp?
Lettuce, tomatoes. I mean, I like eggs. I'm not vegan.
You can't even put mayonnaise.
Yeah, I can. I'm not vegan.
Oh, you're not a vegan. That's
no.
right. A vegan can't put mayonnaise on a
no,
sandwich.
No, they can't.
Right?
They have
that's
fake
eggs.
Mayonnaise, but it doesn't
fake
really
mayonnaise.
Taste good. Yeah,
oh, yeah, that's
really
like,
bad.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Why would you eat fake anything? It's like eating fake ice cream. I mean,
I've actually had that, too.
Tofu ice cream.
That stuff's nasty, but the sandwich seems pretty good.
What is it?
Soy ice cream. They make ice cream.
Soy ice cream?
Or like coconut milk.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Is mom a vegetarian?
No, she's not.
She's a Venturini.
Let's go with that. She's, she's a Venturini.
Do you know what? You know what? You have no idea what I'm talking about.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
That happens to be my last name.
Okay, I kind of like figure that out a little bit. Not really.
Not really.
No.
All right. We'll ask you another question. An easy one, though. This is called a softball.
Okay.
What's your favorite season of the year? Fall.
No, I like winter.
You like winter?
Yeah, I like to snowboard. I've been snowboarding for about 8 years. I go down to New Hampshire about 4 times a year, twice in the winter.
Now, wait, you don't go down to New Hampshire.
Up to New Hampshire. I'm so sorry. I do that every single time. Everybody always corrects me.
They correct you,
and I'll never get it right.
I shouldn't correct you. I shouldn't have corrected you. I mean, I did it as a joke.
It's okay.
Just
no, I will never get that right.
Where do you go in New Hampshire?
Down, I don't even know where it is. I go down to Cranmore.
I know where that is, yeah. Cranmore. Yeah, that's up in Conway, near Conway, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Loon Mountain too.
Loon Mountain. I know where that is. Yeah.
Nice mountain.
I almost skied there once.
You almost skied there. Why not?
I never skied.
You never skied?
I've had 5 knee operations. I ain't doing any skiing.
That's not a good idea.
You never banged up your knee skiing? Because I'd be so afraid of that.
No, I broke my tailbone. I got foot swept by one of the.
Foot swept?
Yeah, one of the things on the rope toe grabbed my ankle. I was texting my mom, and I got foot swept onto the ice and broke my tailbone.
Now, do you text while you drive?
No, don't text while I drive.
Not at all?
Not at all. My brother's friend died texting while driving.
Oh,
so
no kidding.
Yeah, that really scares me away. It should scare anyone away, just the thought of it. So.
That's how I broke my knee. I had my knee replaced because of a woman texting while she was driving. I was getting ready to turn down my street.
Really?
And I had just bought a brand new Toyota, first new car I bought in like 15 years. And I'm stopped. Directional on, waiting to turn to go down my street. Bang, woman plows right into me. And I smashed my knee against the dash. I ended up having 2 meniscus operations. Neither one of them worked. Then they replaced my knee. And then last year they had to take it out because it got infected and wait 66 days before they could put a new knee in. And now that I found out last week or 2 weeks ago that it's not connected. They got to take it out again and redo it again. For the 5th time, they got to operate on my knee.
That's nuts. See, texting and driving is not worth it.
It's not good.
Neither is drinking and driving. Anything.
Very dangerous, texting while driving. Years ago, there was a guy, long before texting was even popular, there was a contractor in Bristol, I think it was. He was driving along and he was texting a business deal, and he ran over 2 girls. He killed one of them and maimed the other one. He was texting. He went to jail.
And not good. Now he has to live with that. And
exactly.
I'm glad you shouldn't be texting while driving.
Well, that should be your whole thing, your platform. Well, part of your platform instead of world peace. Is that what they tell you? They don't tell you to do that anymore.
No.
World peace.
No, that's really, no, we don't. Well, I mean, everyone wants world peace, but that's really stereotypical.
Everyone doesn't want world peace. Some of the rich people make a lot of money with war. You know that, right? Did you know that?
Well,
on purpose, they do that. Yeah.
I do believe that.
Oh, by the way, and I know you know the answer to this question. Every one of those girls in the top 5 had the same first sentence in their response. What was it?
That's a very good question.
They all said the same thing.
Did.
That's a very good question.
Yeah,
you know what that's called?
I'm thinking.
That's a stall.
I don't have an answer yet. But
that's a stall.
Yeah.
That's a stall. What was weird about that whole thing was 3 of the 5 girls that stumbled, they all seemed, and it was they were tough questions.
Yeah, they were, I will give them that. They were very tough questions.
Yeah, and you wouldn't think that they'd ask them questions like that.
No, not in the USA system. I'd expect it from the America system.
Why? What's the difference, America, U.S.?
America calls themselves a scholarship program, so they're very political and they're very tough with their questions.
Oh, really?
And, USA just tends to be more general topics. They were all very focused this year on what Donald Trump said, I believe. That's what
messed everything up for you, for the whole pageant, right? USA pageant, right?
Well, yeah, there was that.
That's why it ended up not being on NBC. It was supposed to be on NBC,
right? Yeah,
that's
exactly what happened.
Because Donald Trump made that crazy, went off crazily. And not that he's totally wrong, I might add, but because of the way he said it and how badly he came across. You know, some of the things, he's not totally wrong. He's not right, but he's not totally wrong on everything he says. But the way he threw it out there,
it's a sensitive subject. You have to be careful.
He's a little too much, and that's what happens with guys that are, in the position he's in. He's got a lot of money, and he can afford to be as arrogant as he is. But it doesn't work well with the American public.
No.
There's a percentage that will work well with, but not the majority of people won't.
Yeah, some people like, I guess, how honest he is. But there's a point where you can't be brutally honest on national television.
Well, who says he's honest?
Well, honest with his thoughts.
Honest with his thoughts.
Mind. That's, no, I don't mean he's honest because he's correct. I mean he's honest with his thoughts.
No, he was lucky. He was lucky to be born after his father because he inherited a whole lot of money. He's not a self-made man. Donald Trump is not. He didn't start from nothing and make a lot of money. He started with, I don't know, $30 million or something Dad gave him. Right. I mean, you or I could make that with.
I'd be happy with $1 million.
$1 million?
Yeah.
Well, nowadays $1 million nothing.
Well, I know. Right now I have like a $40 paycheck a week.
$40?
Yeah, I really get a lot of hours. So.
Oh, where do you work?
Brood Awakenings.
You do?
I do.
Dave, is it a guy named Dave?
Dave, yes, Dave's great.
Yeah.
You know him?
I come up with his name out of the clear blue sky.
Oh, well, yeah,
right. Right?
That's true.
Yeah. In fact, he built a couple big places. He's got a big place. Where did I see it? I saw it yesterday down in South County.
The biggest one is the one that I work at. It's
where is it?
Bald Hill.
That's right. Bald Hill Road, near Jake Kaplan's. Near the car, company.
Yeah.
Yeah, the fancy car company.
Right, yeah, right next to the Jaguar dealership.
Exactly, mm-hmm. Jake Kaplan, Jaguar. Jaguar.
But
he also has one in South County Commons.
Yes,
he has one
in
South County Commons, yes.
Yeah.
So you tell him Bob said hi when you
I
see
will.
Him, all right?
I will.
So we're going to see you with the pageant. Is that going to be televised, your pageant, do you know?
I don't believe so.
No?
But, no.
Now, when is it? What's the actual date?
I believe it's on July. No,
it's August. August,
yeah,
right?
Sorry. August 6th.
August 6th.
Yes.
In
Cocoa Keys in New Hampshire. New Jersey.
I messed you all up. Cocoa Keys in
New Jersey.
Jersey.
Yes, yeah. The Cocoa Keys Resort.
Oh, that'll be fun, though.
Yeah.
That'll be great for you. Your boyfriend going down there with you?
I'm trying to convince him.
You're trying to convince? I thought it'd be the other way around. I thought it'd be the other way around. You going down there with her?
Yeah, I'm
going to go. All right, good.
You said it now. You've committed. You can't.
You're committed. You're committed. You're all done, kid. You're all done. We got Jason. You got another?
Yes, I do.
What do you got for me?
Well, to my fellow viewers, if you'll allow me to speak in the camera.
Speak in the camera. Go ahead, Jason. It's your floor.
You've seen me set everything up
in
your studio. So, in the history of an Hour with Bob show, Bob, my goal after the routine is over with is to get you to say to me from the bottom of your heart, out of all the illusionists you've ever seen live, that what I'm going to show you is the absolute best illusion you will have ever seen in your life.
Wait a minute now, that would be very difficult, and I'll tell you why.
Okay.
I've seen David Copperfield twice.
Well, we'll see. It's in studio.
All right, we're gonna see that one. I'm waiting for that.
Okay.
It's your floor.
Ladies and gentlemen, Maestro, if you please, flight has evolved. Wrong one. Flight has evolved from Da Vinci's primitive helicopters and planes to the military's Apaches and stealth bombers. For thousands of years, many magicians have tried and failed to answer a question that has for so long been asked. Is human weight lighter than air? Well, tonight, I'm about to give you the answer. I'd like to present Air a Dodge.
Air a Dodge.
I'll never leave you, but fate has come to silence me. Darkness is all that I see. I cannot reach you, and soon the earth will cover me. It's become so hard to breathe. Forever is waiting, the final steps you're taking.
impressive. Pretty impressive, Jason. Wow. That's the best I've seen on this show, that's for sure.
That's why
no,
it's called.
No, that is excellent. That is excellent. Give him another hand. That was excellent. How did it feel to float like that?
Kind of weird, but it felt good. I even didn't feel scared at all. It was fun.
Yeah, great job. Great job. All right, guys, give us another song. The Box of Birds, after Jason Morel levitated his daughter. That was good. Very good. Good job. Good job. I'm impressed.
All right. You can find our EP on Bandcamp, by the way.
Ready?
One, two, three, four. Show me the ocean, so you take me by the hand. Show me the hydrogen, oxygen blend. But I gotta tell you, buddy, I gotta tell you, man, that if you take one step closer, I will knock you in the sand. Now you're walking home. You hop behind the curtain and take a bath. No, no, no one's dabbling. No, no, no one's thinking sin. No, no, no one's calling to see if you'll come out clean. You woke up in a tizzy. You had a dream about the man who stole your innocence when you were just a kid. And he's sitting on the couch again and he turns up the fan. Says if you know what's good for you, you'll shut your mouth. Now you're walking home on the moon. Take a bath. No, no, no one's taboo, man. No, no, no one's thinking sin. No, no, no one's coming to see if you come out clean. You wouldn't recognize me now. Weight is fluctuating, evaporating into a cloud. Rain is pouring down. Rain is pouring down. One, two, three, four.
Of birds. Now wait a minute. Like, who's talking over here, Charlie? You know,
hey.
What kind of music is that?
What do we consider it? Indie folk rock.
Indie folk rock. Now where's that from? Is that somebody's song or is that your own stuff? Or what are you doing?
Steph writes a lot of the lyrics. We write together, and then we bring it to the band, and the band adds their parts and kind of fleshes it all out.
Yeah.
Pretty good. And thank you. Very quite good. Quite good. I like it. It's nice. It's light. It's easy listening, I would call it, right?
Yeah.
Good.
And what do I have here? I have a CD. Is this your first one?
It's our first one.
First CD. You come out with this when? How long ago?
June 27th was the release date.
June 27th? Not even a month ago.
Yep.
Not even a month ago. Two or 3 weeks ago, right? 3 weeks ago.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Almost 3 weeks ago. How do you like that? Now, that's talent. You people got talent. Hey, you people got talent. I got no talent. You guys got talent. Everybody's got talent. Except me. Anyway, we brought our dancer back because she did such a nice job. How you doing, Leah?
I'm good.
What do you think of the show so far? You guys came all the way down from Waltham, right? To be here. Mm-hmm. And you came all the way up from Coventry to be here.
Yeah.
The band came from Brighton and
Somerville.
Somerville. Now, where is Somerville? That's north of Boston, is it?
North, yep.
North of Boston. It's what?
Adjacent to Cambridge.
Adjacent to Cambridge. Yeah. Oh, excuse me. Well, where is it in relationship to Waltham?
Got me.
You don't do any traveling. You know, when I was your age, when you hear that from old people all the time. When I was your age.
Somerville don't like to leave Somerville or Cambridge.
No? Well, people say that about Rhode Islanders, but I've been to 30 or 40 countries in the world. I've been on five continents.
Well, yeah, it's one thing to travel the world. It's another thing to travel to Waltham. No offense to people
of Waltham. Well, you know what I used to do when my kids were small? Is I used to pick take a map, and you pick an area of the state, mm-hmm. and go to that area. I've been on every route in the state of Rhode Island, and I've been on every major route in New England. And it's something fun to do. It really is fun to do, to see how other, it's amazing. You don't even have to travel that far to see the cultural differences you'll see in different areas of New England, even just New England. And like, say for instance, and you want to go further, you want to go to Montreal, like she talks about New Hampshire. You want to go to Montreal. Montreal is a 6.5 hour ride from here.
There a couple weeks ago.
From Boston, it's only a 5 hour ride. Or from Somerville, it's only about a 5 hour ride. 4.5, 5 hours. Well, it depends. Well, you don't drive like me. I make it from Pawtucket, Rhode Island in 6 hours to Montreal, Canada, right downtown, yeah. St. Catherine Street, 6 hours. Your favorite kind of car is, Leah?
Mercedes.
I knew you were going to say that. Dad drives one.
Mom.
Oh, excuse me. What does Dad drive? A Volkswagen? No, what does he drive?
He drives a Durango.
A Dodge Durango, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Does he like the Durango better than the Mercedes? He can't.
I can't tell.
No, you can't tell. You couldn't. Well, it's probably because he's so darn big. He's 6'7". he wears bolts on his feet. Got a 15.5 shoe.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Now, are you the only child?
No, I have an older brother who is 27.
Yep.
Yeah. But he lives in Chicago.
Oh, wow. Wow. And you, how many in your family? Any? Just you?
I have 6 siblings in total.
Cut it out.
I know.
Really? Yeah. You didn't tell me that.
I know.
You shocked me with that one.
I know.
6 siblings.
Yeah. Well, some are step, but, you know, I count them all the same.
Right, yeah.
I have
Do you
one
step
sister.
On them?
Yeah, the little ones.
The little ones you step on?
I step on them.
That's why you call them step, right?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Step.
You know what the toughest job in the world is?
Being
a stepfather.
That's what my stepdad said.
That is the single toughest job on earth. Been there, done that. I was a stepfather for 3 kids. And you know what they did? When you were nice to them, oh, dad.
Yeah.
When you said, take out the garbage, you're not my father.
Yeah, I know it all too well. I'm sorry to say, but.
Very common. Yeah. I was going to write a book about stepfathering.
Really?
Fathering's tough enough, but stepfathering's even worse because even fathering's tough because what do kids say? Even athletes, if they hit a home run or score a touchdown, what do they do when the camera's on them? Hi, who? Hi, Mom. They never say hi, Dad. Well, Dad, you work just as hard as Mom did. Maybe even harder in many cases. What? How about Dad? Say hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
There you go. Anyway, thank you, ladies, for stopping by and spending an hour with Bob. Have you had fun?
Yes.
Was it worth the trip?
Yes.
You? What do you think?
Yes, thank you for inviting me.
Thank you for having me.
Well, I'm glad you guys could come. That was nice of you to show up, and I wish you well, and I know you'll do well. Both of you are going to do well. You got to do well in life. You got the attitude, you got the personality, you got the looks, and you got the talent. Yeah. And that's why you got to do well. Just like the box of birds. Yes, thank you guys for showing up. Thanks for spending an hour with Bob.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for driving all the way down from Somerville in Brighton, Massachusetts. Check out 10 Centola Street. See if Ruthie's still there.
Yeah.
And, of course, Jason, thank you for stopping by. And, of course, thrilling us with your master tricks. Or with magic tricks.
Illusionism.
Illusionism. All right. Thank you, Jason, for spending an hour with Bob for the fifth time.
The honor is mine.
Well, I thank you for spending an hour with Bob. And thank you, Mom, Dads, and for coming here and bringing your daughter to spend some time with us. And where's the boyfriend? Is he there? Where'd he go?
I don't know.
Well, again, folks, thank you for spending an hour with Bob. And again, if you want to be part of the crew, get a hold of me. Go on Facebook, Bob Venturini. Go on Facebook, An Hour with Bob. Go on Facebook, Bob's Big Adventure. Or email me, ventbob@gmail.com. And join the crew of An Hour with Bob. Twice a week. 3 hours a night, twice a week. I mean, twice a month, I'm sorry. Twice a month. 3 hours a night. All right. Thank you for spending an hour with Bob. Take us out of here. Give us a quick hit.
I'd bury my bones in your backyard. Because I do a lot when you're gone from home. You're always leaving me alone.
If I was a cat,
I'd land on my feet. Stuck in your tree. You can never reach me.